This is Italian football lover channel, my friends. Italy won 4-2 against Spain after penalty kicks and became up to final in Euro 2020. You can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. I want to talk about the tactics and analysis of this game. Italy played in Mancini's classical formation 4-3-3 and Spain played in 4-3-3 formation of Luis Enrique. In this game, on the midfield, every time Barella moved higher and made higher press on Sergio Busquets, and at the same time this player Pedri moved higher and made higher press on Jorginho, and at the same time sometimes Immobile covered off Sergio Busquets with his shadow. On the midfield, Verratti and Koke played close to each other, and really in Spain attacks, sometimes this player Oyarzabal tucked infield and he played close to Chiellini. And at the same time, this player Olmo played close to Bonucci. These two players played close to center backs of Italy. At the same time, every time Olmo made press on Di Lorenzo on the forward. Sometimes in Italy, Italy defense line turned into three. Emerson moved higher and wider. He supported the attacks and Insigne tucked infield. Really, sometimes Immobile dropped deep and he received the balls on the midfield. Really, Emerson found a few goal positions in the first half. Sometimes he carried the ball to the forward, Festi Emerson, and he tucked infield and really forced the Spain defense, right wing back of Spain defense in the first half, especially Emerson. In Spain, Sergio Busquets played more close to defense line, and sometimes in Spain attacks, Jordi Alba moved higher and wider, and Italy's Spain defense line turned into three. At the same time, Spain had the ball more, and really Spain played more effectively in this game. I accept this, and really the first half has been finished 0-0. Really, in the second half, there was a tactical battle between of these two coach, Roberto Mancini and Luis Enrique, and in the second half there were so many substitutions, but Italy found the goal firstly with Federico Chiesa, and Immobile made to assist Chiesa. I want to talk about substitutions. There were so many important substitutions in the second half. Firstly, really in the Spain game, this player Oyarzabal and other player out on the forward, really Morata and Gerard Moreno replaced of them. And like this, after these substitutions, Gerard Moreno played on the right forward like this nine number, and Morata played as a central forward, and instead of Ferran Torres, and Olmo played on the left, and Luis Enrique pulled Olmo to the left, and Morata played as a central forward. But after Morata got into the pitch, really Spain played more effectively on the forward, and sometimes Morata came close to right, Gerard Moreno moved tuck infield, and really they forced the center of Italy defense, and really Olmo gave very critical passes between and behind of Italy defense line in the second half. And at the same time, on the midfield in Spain, this player Koke out and 16 number Rodri replaced of him. And in Italy, first substitution, Immobile out on the forward, and really this player Berardi replaced of him. After this substitution, Insigne played as a central forward in Italy. Insigne played here like this, and Berardi played on the right like this. Berardi and Roberto Mancini put Chiesa to the left after these substitutions. Italy was so weak on the midfield, and Verratti out, and this player replaced of him, Pessina replaced of him, really Pessina. And other substitution, Barella out on the center of the midfield, and Locatelli replaced of him, Locatelli. But I want to indicate that Insigne was tired a little bit, and Insigne out, and Belotti replaced of him. Belotti. And really on the right back Azpilicueta out in Spain team and Llorente replaced of him, 6 number Llorente. Really after Llorente got into the pitch, he played more offensively. He moved higher and wider, supported the attacks. When this player Llorente moved higher and wider, Rodri came dropped off the cover of his position, and Rodri came close to right back, and really Italy's formation turned into 4-2-3-1 after these substitutions, and Pessina played more close to Belotti, and Pessina played like this here, and Locatelli and Jorginho, these two players played as a two pivot front of the defense line. Jorginho and Locatelli played front of the Italy defense line. Italy played in 4-2-3-1 formation, and Pessina played more close to Belotti. But really, Spain team found the goal with Alvaro Morata. Really, Olmo tuck infield, and his pass between of Bonucci and Chiellini. Morata got into the Italy box, and he scored the goal of Spain. And really, at the back post, when Spain developed attacks from the left, really Spain found one more goal position, but he missed this clear goal position at the back post. At the same time, really Emerson out for Italy in this game. It was substitution, and Mancini pulled Di Lorenzo to the left back. Di Lorenzo played on the left back, and Toloi replaced of Emerson, and Toloi played as a right back. Really, Spain forced the wing backs of Italy all the game, and really Italy waited on their own half pitch, and 90 minutes of this game has been ended. Really 1-1 draw, and in extension times there were another substitutions for these two teams, and Sergio Busquets out and Alcantara replaced of him. After this substitution, Pedri, Rodri played instead of Sergio Busquets here, like this. And at the same time, Thiago Alcantara played close to right here. And again, Llorente played more offensively. This time, Alcantara played close to right back, and he dropped off the cover of Llorente in Spain attacks. Really, last substitutions for these two teams. This player was injured a little bit on the defense, Eric Garcia, and Pau Torres replaced of him. After these substitutions, Pau Torres played here, and Laporte played here like this. They changed their positions between each other. Laporte played as a right center back, and this player, Pau Torres, played as a left center back in Spain. But really, these two teams couldn't find any goal in extension times, and Chiesa out, last substitution for Italy, and Bernardeschi replaced of him. These two teams made six substitutions all the game with extension times, and really in penalty kicks, Italy won this game 4-2, and Jorginho scored the last penalty of Italy. But really, it was so exciting, and so exciting game. But really, in this game, Italy played so ineffective, and if Italy plays like this, in final game will be so hard for Italy. But although everything, nevertheless, really Italy deserved to play in final generally in this tournament. All my analysis and all my comments like this. You can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. Please open up your notification bells. Thank you very much. See you on my next videos, beautiful people. Bye!